Now back to Let's Chat with Tita Gracie, only here on V81 Radio.
And we're back, and tonight we're exploring the wonderful world of music. And tonight's show will not be complete if we do not go into the heart and mind of our next audience. He's one of Manila's foremost jazz musicians, and over the years, he has thrilled a lot of us with his wonderful performances on the saxophone. Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to call back Saxman extraordinaire, Mr. Pete CANZON.
Hello.
Hi, Pete. You know, unang-una talaga nagpapasalamat ako that you could be with me tonight. Medyo matagal na rin tayong hindi nagkikita-kita.
Oh, yeah, lalo nagka-pandemic pa. You know?
Oo nga eh. So how have you been coping with the whole pandemic, Pete?
Well, okay lang, good and bad, you know. Bad because wala na masyadong gigs, di ba?
So, oo nga.
Yung tinutugtugan ko, okay? Alam, you know, bad because hindi na ako nakakapag-social sa mga usual people that I get along, I mean, like being with, you know, sa mga bars.
Yes.
Well, good in a way that you have time. May time kasi sa art mo, sa music mo to develop. And to see more grounds, you know, para mag-grow ka pa, you know. Kasi kulang ang lifetime para talaga hindi naman ma-perfect, but to really get what you want and then be able to share it, you know.
Yes. Art. And alam ko yung mga nagsusubaybay sa'yo, they follow you wherever you play. I know because I was one of your fans and I still am. Medyo naputo lang kasi there was a time na I was not able to go out anymore. Pero prior to that, talagang kung saan nag-gig si Pete CANZON, pupunta talaga ako. Kasi sax is my favorite jazz instrument. And talagang nung nagkakilala tayo many years ago, if I remember correctly, dun pa sa bar ni Freddy Aguilar, di ba?
Yeah.
Nung dati sa bar ni Ka Freddy, and talagang walang pipigil sa akin, rain or, you know, may bagyo or what, pumupunta talaga ako doon para makinig ka.
Yeah, salamat Gracie, salamat. Layo noon, no? Anyway,
Ganong katagal ka ba nag-play with the band of Ka Freddy?
Well, mga more or less 20 years, you know?
So you saw Freddy Aguilar talaga from way back, and you were with him throughout his career, almost his entire career pala.
Almost naman. Yung some songs when it was speaking, you know, I was with him already. And then we were able to do 3 albums, you know, impromptu albums and all that. Pero syempre hindi na masyadong commercial because medyo naging jazzy-jazzy yung band.
Because oo. Eh, nandun ka pa. So, talagang, ano, I remember early on, no, you played with so many different bands, di ba? I mean, if I remember correctly, the first time na kita-kita on the stage was all the way in the 80s sa Kalesa Bar, sa Hayat.
Yeah. I was with the Manila band. I was with Batukada. I was with Pinoy Rock, Anak Bayan. Actually, nakasama ko ng lahat yan. You know, I mean, I was with Lolita Pragbon, you know, after a scene. Marami pa. I mean, like, it's a small community that we, ikot lang kami na ikot, you know, ito, rock and roll and all that. Anyway, it's one music anyway, you know, so wala namang barriers yan, you know.
But talagang, over the last few years, nung medyo nung mga 2012, 2013, yun yung panahon na madalas kitang mapanood eh, sa bar ni Ka Freddy Aguilar sa Malate. No? Oo, and then napansin ko na talagang more or less mga standards, mga jazz, no? And then may mga pop pieces ka rin na pina-play during your, the course of your show, no? So medyo malawak talaga, ang lawak talaga ng repertoire mo, kaya saludong-saludo kami sa'yo, Pete.
Salamat, salamat. Well, to think, nag-start ako, Beatles, bago mag-Beatles, you know, standard and Beatles and all the way, non-stop. Though yung father ko, he doesn't want me to play music, you know, so gusto niya maging arkitekto, so ginawa ko rin yun. But eventually, I have to tell him that, you know, I have to stop doing architecture and I have to play music kasi yun talaga yung love ko eh, you know.
Okay. Oo, yun nga eh. Yung mga parents kasi nung araw, syempre they, the last thing they will think of is maging musikero ka or maging musical artist. Ang una nilang sasabihin, magtapos ka ng kurso na business or architecture or medicine or law. Pero talagang when your groove is in the heart, you have to follow it, 'di ba, Pete?
Yeah. In fact, hindi nila alam habang nag-aaral ako, tumutugtog ako eh, kaya 5-year course yung architecture, siguro nakuha ko ng 6.5. Kasi I'm playing, hindi niya alam, you see.
So, hindi niya alam the whole time?
Hindi. Wow. Ayoko naman saktan sila, you know? Pero ayoko rin saktan ng loob ko because parang pakiramdam ko, half of my life is art and music. But, you know, parang siyempre during those traditional times, hindi nila maintindihan yun because wala namang ganyan, di ba? You have to have a job like that, you know? But anyway,
I remember, I remember there was even a time that, bilib ako sa inyo eh, kasi parang na kayong halos ginagawang, talagang pag nagre-request yung mga tao, alam na alam nyo lahat ng kanta. Doon ako nagugulat eh, yung banda nyo dati, talagang, kahit na wala sa present repertoire nyo nung gabi yon, no, may magpapasa ng note, ganun, paano mo na, I'm sure all these years na nasanay ka na ng mga audience request, no?
Yeah.
Pero wala sa repertoire that night, biglang may magpapasa ng papel. Can you play kung ano man yung hit, no? How did you cope?
Well, siyempre, I mean, over the years and years, you know, naririnig mo na yan, and then it's only a matter of scales naman and melodies, the same arrangement, you know, unless it's a special arrangement. Pero, I mean, kasi ako, mas malakas sa akin yung tenga eh, and then heart. That's all. You know, that's all I want to be with, my music. You know, I'm sorry, you know, I started playing piano, violin, guitar when I was 7 years old. Kasi traditional din sa pamilya, you have to learn that, you know, something like that. But hindi ko siya talaga, it didn't appeal to me. So, ang nangyari, pagpasok ng Beatles, I fell in love with playing the drums, you see. So nag-drama ko, and then kumakanta, and then transfer sa gitara. I went with the chunod-chunod the band. Bands like you don't even know, I guess, now. Because for a long ways, I'm really that, you know, that old.
So, old, kasama ko to.
Siyempre, mas maganda naman ako. So lahat pinataanan ko from Dave Clark 5 and all that, you know, sila Gary Lewis and the Playboy and then rock and roll. So drums, guitar, you know, and then finally, I really subdued to saxophone because, you know, I think that's where my heart really want to stay, you know.
Yes, ay talaga, natutuwa ako kasi unang-una, ang dami mong yung journey mo as an artist, no? Well, it's never really a straight path, no? From the time you start until the time right now. It takes a long while, sabi nga ng kanta ng Beatles, the long and winding road of a musical artist. No? The journey of a musical artist is truly the long and winding road. And that's so true for you, Pete, no?
Yeah, and nasanay na rin ako, I don't know what is normal and abnormal for me because, you know, I get heartaches and I play music. I get that. I play music. I feel happy. I play music. You know, everything to me, you know, that's why I guess that's my life.
Yes. Sabi nga nila eh, the, sometimes music is the only medicine for the heart and the soul to heal.
Very true.
Broken-hearted ka, kung nabigo ka, you just have to listen to the, your favorite music, or there's a piece that will bring you out of the darkness, no?
Yes. That's very true. That's what I do. I feel like that, you know. I just play my saxophone. I have to play my saxophone all the time. It's like a staple for my life now, you know.
Yeah. Go ahead.
Yeah, and be able to really, it's unfair, like if you just play it and then, you know, meditate, you know, love what you do, and then sharing it. It has to be a positive energy that you can share to people para masaya lahat, para walang, ano, you know.
Oo, kasi pag nasa entablado ka, no, if you're on the stage and, you know, you're in a club or in a gig, no, and ang expectation ng mga tao, you can feel the energy, you know, when you're on stage and you're about to play, nafe-feel mo and na parang galak na galak sila, they can't wait to hear your first note.
Yeah, me, I have to be one with them, you know. I have to be, and then feel them, and then be able now to present, you know. I mean, to share, you know. Ganon. Yeah, sometimes aloof ako because just people like sometimes you know, hindi nila. When I go to play, they don't be just. For a while, I get aloof, but later on, you know, I can what do you call, blend with them and all that.
Yes, and I've seen you in action in so many gigs before. At nakakatuwa kasi yung response ng mga audience sa'yo, no? Very warm palagi kasi you really connect with them, Pete, no? And and whenever somebody wants to do a jam with you, you know, whether they play another wind instrument or they go on the keyboard or they go, parang ang bilis-bilis mong makafit ng makaharmonize.
Yeah.
Yung parang talagang natutuwa ako sa artistry mo, ang bilis mo makaharmonize with the people you jam with.
Yeah, but in fact, you know, I want them to feel comfortable. Plus, you know, these people probably are not really players, but they have their own art in them. And I want to help them, I mean, if they join and jam, to really explore on it, you know, I mean, to really go deeper on it through the music that we're making, or probably we adjust that. Because yes, everyone is an artist in their own right. And I love that. It's only sometimes like, you know, I started early and then probably I can play scales here and there. But these people, I mean, like these jammers, will find a way to one day, you know, they'll be really good and polished musicians. That's all.
With yes. That,
you know, I grew up in a community where people, I mean, musicians, co-musicians, don't really help musicians. They now, I don't know what kind of competition is that. But now you see, I mean, like that's, I feel it's not the way. That's not the way. So, you know, I welcome everybody and you learn from them, you know. They learn from you. Everybody learns from each other, you know. It's really, that's the way art and music is. That's so far what I know, you know.
Yes. And I'm sure na madaming mga sax players na inspirado sa'yo. Dahil I've also seen some of these sax players that come to the club, they bring their own instruments, and then when the minute comes, when you call them up to jam with you, you know, nakakataba ng puso because talagang feel na feel nila yung pag nag-umpisa ka ng unang riff, tapos papasok sila, tapos bibigyan mo sila ng solo, then you see, you can feel the joy, no? You can feel the joy when they perform with Pete Canzon on stage.
Well, you know, they're like my children. I love that, you know. I mean, people who want to jump, they, you know, that's no problem. They can always jump with me, you know.
Yeah, I remember there have been even a couple of times na medyo lumakas ang loob ko at nasa microphone na rin ako.
you sing well, Gracie. You're okay.
Well, sa totoo lang, you know, I know that one of these days, you know, pagtapos na tong pandemic or pwede na tayong bumalik sa mga gigs, makikita mo ako dun sa isang gig mo one of these nights.
Wow.
Dahil talagal ko na inaasam yan.
Wow, salamat. Yeah.
Yes, and I know that our audience now is excited. para madinig ang iyong special na ihandog sa atin ngayong gabi. Ano ba itong piece na to, Pete?
Well, it's an old-time music. Mga 1961, tinugtog ni Herbie Manto. And then, marami nang nag-follow na nag-version, nag-cover niya. And it's a simple song wherein you can do a lot of weaving around. You can do a lot. It's so basic. It's so nice, but yet you can make it complicated. You can make it simple. Make it even love song. But it's a traditional, supposed to be a rockish type, you know, but it's jazzy type also. Well, this one is called "Come Home, Baby."
Okay. So, without further ado, ladies and gentlemen, mga kaibigan ko, alam kong matagal nyo nang gustong madinig ang ating pinakamamahal na Pete Canzon, the one and only Manila's jazz great Pete Canzon on the saxophone right here on Let's Chat with Tita Gracie. Take it away, Pete. Just flows ang there's para ka naglalaro sa mga notes, no? Ang ganda.
Yeah, enjoy it.
Ladies and gentlemen, that was Pete Canzon with that fantastic jazz piece. Alam ko na jazz is coming back. A lot of people love jazz and it's coming back. Actually, it really never went away, but kung gusto niyo pang madinig yung mga ibang nire-record ni Pete, solo saxophone, just visit his Facebook page. Madami kayong madidinig na mga pieces doon. Pete Canzon, Manila's jazz saxophonist extraordinaire. And we are so delighted and honored to have him with us tonight. So don't go away. We're just gonna go on a short break. And when we come back, we're gonna go for another interview with another sax player with his unique style and artistry. So come right back after this.
We'll be back shortly with Tita Gracie. Let's chat with Tita Gracie only here on V81 Radio.